patients crammed into a sports complex there. More than a third of them are being treated for health-related issues. More than 2,200 medically treated, more than 60% with respiratory infections. And 101 cases of lice, 4 cases of chickenpox, serious concerns about the prospect of hepatitis because of the unsanitary conditions in which they're living. Other concerns also being outlined by the Department of Homeland Security. They've identified now more than 600 criminals and gang members that are traveling in that caravan. Joining me tonight to talk about the growing crisis on our border, security concerns, and the president's fight to build a wall, of course, Steve Rogers, a Trump 2020 advisory board member, former Navy lieutenant commander, and a former FBI Joint Terrorism Task Force member. Steve, great to have you.
Pleasure to be here.
Let's start with that caravan, the president doing the right thing, securing the border. He's being attacked, as he is always, no matter what he does, by the establishment, by the left, by the right, by the Wall Street Business Roundtable, Chamber of Commerce, and then, of course, Chuck Schumer and all of his buddies.
Lou, after 9/11, as a military intel officer, I was assigned the FBI Joint Terrorism Task Force. And we were watching. We were gathering intelligence and information about that border. And we had concerns back then, way back then. Who's crossing the border? Of course, our concern was somebody would bring a dirty bomb across that border. But we knew. We knew there was a drug cartel. We knew there was human trafficking. Nothing was done until Donald Trump became president of the United States.
By the way, he's the first president and first presidential candidate to speak openly about the drug cartels and their role in corruption, not only in Mexico, but at the border. By the way, the American people are coming to the realization that corruption south of the border means there's corruption to the north of the border. And we're not doing nearly enough to fight that.
He's delivering on his promise that he would protect the American people. When you hear about 600 gang members this week, a gang member from MS-13 was arrested. I mean, my goodness, how many did we not catch? So when he talks about protection, he meant it and he's delivering.
Yeah, and by the way, MS-13 gang members are throughout the country, for crying out loud. This is the first president to actually do something about it. His Justice Department making headway, one of its few public, at least, accomplishments to this point. The Cohen guilty plea, your reaction to what the left-wing media is making of it. Here's a business deal that was never done, and now the great... I mean, you listen. I don't know if you saw the clips that we had of the left-wing media just going nuts. There's
Lou,
no deal.
Lou, when I was doing investigations and police work and had a witness, a so-called witness, change his story a dozen times, how do you believe him? Where do you believe him? Look, Michael Cohen's out to save his own hide. And if he thinks he's going to save his hide on the back of the president of the United States, well, he's got another story coming his way.
The president's saying that he's going to play tough with the Democrats if they continue to frustrate him and attack him. That he's going to release some documents that they will find very disturbing, the documents about them. What do you make of this, of the promise, the threat, however you would start?
Oh, I believe that he knows what's in those documents. Timing is everything. I know he cares for this country, and I know that perhaps he doesn't want to do damage to the country, even though it's the Democrats. He cares about our country. But if he has to use those documents to defend himself, go ahead. You know what, Lou? The American people, despite what the polls say, I'm out there. They support this president. They value his judgment.
You know, I'm troubled by a number of reports that are coming out. One is that there would be a framework of a deal that he might reach with, and this may be driven by Chinese propaganda in this country, that he might come up with a framework that would be satisfactory for a while and defer tariffs rather than continue with the tariffs and stay tough with them. And by the way, if that were the case, there would still be the matter of $500 billion in stolen American intellectual property each and every year. These are disturbing reports, and they're being driven in some measure by, I'll call them what they really are, they're never-Trumpers and establishment rhino Republicans within his own administration.
Well, let's look at that. Let's look at what the president has done already. He has never compromised on the security of this country, never. And I believe that he's going to be driven by that, even with this issue in China.
Well, I think you're exactly right. And I have to wonder, though, when we look at this Mary Kissel appointment, a never-Trumper. I read to the audience a number of the tweets, her absolute pro-China, pro-fanatical, actually, free trade beliefs, and her attacks on the president. What in the world is Mike Pompeo thinking of, and why? How could you even rationalize this?
Well, difficult for us to rationalize it, but I got to tell you, I trust the judgment of the president, and I'm sure he is going to make sure she or anyone else supports his policies. He's the boss, not Mike Pompeo, no one else. He's the president of the United States.
I think that may be a news break for Mike Pompeo based on his most recent hire.
Well,
thanks so much, right. Steve. Great to have you here, Steve Rogers. A new report from the Center for Disease Control.